Today, we're making beef tartare with gyudon flavours. It's a variation that combines two famous dishes, the French beef tartare and the Japanese simmered beef on rice. Both incredible in their own right, and let's merge them in harmony. So, very simple, just like the regular gyudon, we first make our dashi to simmer the onion. Today, I'm just using a sachet, but feel free to make your own dashi. We add just enough water to cook the onion, because we don't want to dilute the flavours unnecessarily. And we bring this to a bare simmer. While that's happening, let's slice some onion. We'll first slice it crosswise to cook. And then, once they're fully cooked, we'll mince them and work them into our beef tartare. Gyudon, for those of you who do not know, is a simmered dish. So the flavours are by definition quite clean, which is perfect for raw beef. We don't want to overpower the delicate taste of the raw beef. While dashi is cooking away, we prepare some scallion. For this particular dish, and gyudon in general, we're only going to use the green part. The white part will be a bit overpowering, and we have the onion for that flavor profile anyway. We'll work some of this in the tartare and save the rest for garnish. Perfect. Now, the dashi is ready. Fish out the sachet, squeeze out the good bits. To that, we add a bit of mirin. Traditionally, they use a sake, but then they would use some sugar to add sweetness. So for me, I just add the mirin, which has the characteristics of the combined results. A bit of soy sauce. We can afford to make the onions saltier than usual because we could adjust the seasoning accordingly with the beef. So, onions now, they go in. We're going to keep it on medium-high heat because we really want the liquid to evaporate and reduce. We don't want to introduce too much moisture to the tartare. So we let this simmer for about 5 minutes until they're fully softened. All right, after 5 minutes, onions have softened completely and they've taken on the beautiful color of the soy sauce. So now, stove off, we fish them out to cool down. Perfect. Now, with most of my raw dishes, unless I'm buying the ingredient from a sashimi counter, I always like to give it the quickest heat treatment possible before serving them. Normally, with beef tartare, I would give it a quick sear and it goes into the ice water to stop the cooking. But since this is a simmering dish and we already have a simmering liquid, we're simply going to add the beef to the boiling liquid for a couple of seconds and stop the cooking with some ice water. So we bring this back to a boil. While beef is completely safe to consume raw, I occasionally see butchers using the same knife for chicken or beef. It's good to be on the safe side. So once we're properly boiling, instant pasteurization of the surface. Go in, turn, straight to the ice water. And we give it time to cool down completely. Then we can make our beef tartare. So, beef comes out. And we pat it dry as much as we can. Today we're using an olive-fed Wagyu from England. And because it's such a tender breed, we're using the Denver so that we have more flavors. With regular beef, I normally just go with the fillet. So, very simple. As you can see, we only barely cook the surface. First into strips. I like a bit of texture in the finished product. So not too fine. I don't like to pound the crap out of the beef. Oh, look at the marbling. It's beautiful. Perfect. So I'm happy with this texture. Into the mixing bowl they go. Now, to that, we add our extremely flavorsome onion. About equal size. So this much. Again, we want to retain some texture. So not too fine. Perfect. They can go in. And this will season the beef immediately. A bit of beni sugar. Pickled raw ginger. That's a mandatory ingredient for all gyudons. But this can be overpowering, so not too much. We start with this and we taste. Perfect. And this also adds a bit of texture. Now, the first round of scallion, just for a bit of freshness and color. Look at that, already so beautiful. And the first round of shichimi togarashi, Japanese seven spice. For me, another mandatory ingredient. Now we mix. We haven't added any oil yet just because the olive-fed wagyu is quite fatty. But if you're using a fillet steak, I would add a dash of extra virgin olive oil at this point. Now we taste. Oh wow, it's incredible. The ginger onion mix really works. Could use a bit more brightness from the scallion, I think. And a small touch of soy sauce. Wow, incredible. The ginger really, really, really brings out so much flavors from the beef itself. Amazing. Now we can plate. Today, for a change, we're going to use a lid of a miso soup bowl to shape our tartare. So, very simple. Perfect. Find our spot, press, carefully remove the lid. Whew, almost thought it wouldn't work. Now, to put the don back into the ghee, we have my daughter's favorite rice cracker, and we just crumble them. Plating has never been my strong suit. A bit of scallion everywhere. And of course, no gyudon of mine is complete without the egg. Today, we'll just use the yolk of a quail egg. Perfect. Oh, how beautiful is that? Final touch, just a tiny bit more shichimi right on top of the egg. And there you have it. A marriage of two of my favorite dishes. This is beef tartare with gyudon ingredients. I really, really hope you enjoy. Wow!